Rock, roll, rock, roll.
You take some music, music, free flowing music, some moving and grooving, rock and roll, dance. Take some hot beats, drums, beats, finger popping and stopping beats. Little dances that look so neat, you see.
I've seen Chairman DeBoer so much. I've had the Horned Rooster on the stage with him before. It's been good.
There's the chairman of the board, and there's everybody else.
And I've been listening to Beach Music my whole life. My parents listen to it. All my friends and family.
I love Beach Music because it'll always be history. Even the young people today love it.
I love Beach Music.
And they are great. They're old band, and they are always will be the best.
What do you think of me doing the middle of the set, taking all my clothes off?
I really don't think that's a good idea.
What?
Reason being, whatever you do, we have to. And I don't look as strong as I used to.
You don't look as strong as you used to.
Yeah, you come out and take power.
Guys, ready for showtime? No, I don't think you're ready. Triangle Music Festival, are you ready for showtime? T, I think you're ready. Introducing Beach Music's finest, General Johnson, Danny Woods, Ken Knott, the chairman of the board.
To happy people.
Yeah.
Let's sing us a happy song.
Give me that beat. Give me that beat. Get them hands up. Come on.
Make a joyful noise. Come on. Come on. Come on.
La 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 la.
Sing that song.
La 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 la.
Let me hear him, band. I must be in Carolina. Yeah, boy.
Everybody wants me to be what they want me to be.
but I can't be nobody else but me. Yeah, I'm sick and tired of trying to please everyone here. Yes, I'm gonna take me some time, steal away and please myself. I'm gonna walk away and won't look back. If anybody asks where I'm at, I'm gone fishing. Yeah. Waste some time.
I'm gone fishing.
Leave my troubles behind.
Gone fishing.
Rest my mind. If I don't get away, I'm gonna lose my mind. Price is too high. My money's low. My friend, you asked me for a loan, ain't my friend no more. What's the use in worrying about things you can't do nothing about? Be happy, go lucky, time or what's it? I'm gonna lock my doors and close my blinds. In my window, I'm gonna leave a sign.
Go fishing, yeah.
Waste some time.
Go fishing.
Leave my troubles behind.
I'm gone fishing.
Rest my mind. If I don't get away, I'm gonna lose my mind. Hey, give me a hand for the boys in the bank. Make it big. Hey, we gonna sing that happy song we practice. Get them up. Sing, sing.
La 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 la. La 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 la. La 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 la. La 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 la.
I'm gonna lock my doors and close my blinds. In my window, I'm gonna leave a sign.
Go fishing.
Waste some time.
Go fishing.
Leave my troubles behind.
Go fishing.
Rest my mind.
Go fishing.
Hey, I'm going fishing.
I was a child star. I was a boy wonder. That was me. Gospel. I was singing my father's group. And I sung with them from Norfolk to New York City. From the age of six, and these just go from church to church, right? And they would take out the silver offering. That's what they call it. A basket for the boy wonder, a basket for the group. And the boy wonder always got four times more than the group did. So when I got to be 12 years old, they had a meeting and they said, they used to call me Shorty. He said, Shorty, you know when Jesus became 12 years old, he was considered a man. And I said, yes, sir. He said, well, you considered a man now, Shorty. So your money's going to have to come into the till with everybody else. And I quit. That was the end of my gospel career at the age of 12. Mm-hmm.
I got some advice for you girls out there. I say I got some advice for you girls out there. So you like drinking them beers that them boys is giving you? I say the girls liking them beers that the boys is giving you. Remember this. If you dance to the music now, you might have to pay to the piper later.
You heard what he said, didn't you? Come on, move it like this.
Get up,
not yet, not yet. Come on, hey.
What are you doing, man?
Big boy, come on.
Through.
much longer can this thing go on? Yeah, my precious, where it be? You wanna be more than just your friend. Need some love.
Need some love.
Yes, believe.
Desperately.
Stop teasing, girl.
Teasing, girl.
Tell me. I played the tune. Get down the beach.
Come on, girl.
Be nice to me.
If you dance.
Hear the music. You got paid to the pipe. Ask your mama.
If you dance.
Hear the music. You got
paid to the pipe. Baby, come on, come on, baby.
Woo!
Baby, come on.
Dance to the music.
Oh.
We gonna dance to everybody sing. Dance to the music. Dance to the music. Look at here. Come here, son. Hey. Little girl, jump with this. Yes. Look here. It's gonna be a hot time in this town tonight. Everybody clap your hands.
Work on it, son.
Clap your hands. Come here, son. I'm ready for you. I'm not yet. Stand right here. You ready? Stand right there.
Oh.
Everybody clap your hands. It's okay. Go ahead, son. Do your thing.
Oh, looky here, looky here.
Oh, he's hot. He's hot. He's hot. How about a round of applause for my friends? I'm going to pay you later. Get out of here. Look here. Tell you what I'm going to do.
Let me introduce you, Dan. Formal introduction. Ladies and gentlemen, Leroy Rogers! It's a party.
Everybody up and down.
It's a party.
Everybody back there.
It's a party.
Everybody up here.
It's a party.
Dance to the music. Yeah, God.
Pay to the piper.
That's your mama.
If you dance to the music.
Yeah, God.
Pay to the piper.
I was in a club one night, mm-hmm. and I were a wild man.
Mm-hmm.
I was jumping, doing splits over chairs and all this crazy stuff.
You were
and,
broke.
Yeah, I was quite broke. And two guys came in, and I was introduced to them. And he said, well, I'll call you later. I want to talk to you. He said, how would you like to join a group? I told him, I said, no,
I don't want that. So he said, I want you to meet this one guy. Isn't that general, the general? I say, okay. He said, Holland, Dozier, and Holland are putting together a group. So I went over to the house.
Lamont Dozier.
And we introduced ourselves, and he sat down to the piano. And he started playing and started singing. And I stood there in amazement. I said, now I heard this guy before. Mm-hmm. But I had no idea that it was who it was. He was playing and singing. And it come to me like a flash. I said, now if I team up with him, mm-hmm. we would have a powerful things. Mm-hmm. Because he had a very unique sound and a very, I could feel the flow, the talent. I say, I think I'm going to go for this. And that's how I met him.
Let me add something to that. Okay. See, what he didn't know is I was in the audience that night, too. Because they took me out. We went and saw a lot of different acts, a lot of different guys that were trying to look for the group, right? And I was in the audience, and here he comes. I ain't never seen nothing like that in my life. Because a lot of people now think he's got a lot of energy. It ain't nothing like it was then. Like he said, he was like, he would line up 10 chairs, run, jump into a split. I'm serious.
It was
just him by himself. Band's raggedy. Band don't sound like nothing. But he's carrying it all on himself. And people are going crazy.
Listen to me good. You better hear me good, girl.
Not yet, not yet.
Now, all you ladies, listen closely. Not yet. You got a good man.
Y'all be his background singer. Be his background singer.
Man, they have a problem. Not yet, not yet. Don't let no smiling, handsome face talk you into giving your love away. Soon as they get what they want, here we go. I say, you
break your rooster before the cuckoo gone. A bird in the hand,
or two in the bush. Hold on to the one that really loves you.
A bird in the hand,
or two in the bush. Hold on, don't run them away, just hold them right there.
Stand right there.
I knew a man that had a good little woman. She was always by his side. She feels a life of love and pride.
Come on, come on.
Soon. Start chasing them girl on the street. All the man's money's gone now. I say
this bird is here. The food group is wrong. A bird in the hand.
But two in the bush. Hold on to the one that really loves you.
A bird in the hand.
But two in the bushes. Hold on. Chicken,
y'all.
It's funky chicken.
Who wants to do the funky chicken?
Who wanna do it? What was that? Let me see that again. Let me see that again. I saw it. Now you girls, hear me. We got four here. They dancing for a prize. I'ma give you your prize. Come on, girl. Hey, go ahead then. Oh yeah.
Work on it, little girl. Doing that funky shit.
Where'd it come from? Don't do no more. I'll tell your mama. Yeah. I'm gonna give you your prize, okay? Oh, we're gonna show you what they're competing for. Stevie, bring it on, baby. Bring it on and take it home.
Go
ahead, big boy. Oh my goodness! Stevie's dream has come true.
His dream has come true.
Y'all do no more. Hey, y'all. We're just having fun. A big round of applause for all our chickens and roosters. Don't forget, I'm a rooster now. Y'all get out of here. Wear your hands in the air. Let me hear some noise out there.
It's a party.
Happy birthday. It's a party. Bend over, let me see you shake a tail feather. Bend over, let me see it. Bend over, let me see you shake a tail feather. Bend over, let me see. Don't let no smiling, handsome face talk you into giving your love away. Soon as they get what he wants, he'll be gone, bye bye.
Your bird, your rooster, be food cooping gone. A bird in the hand,
but two in the bush. Hold on to the one that really loves you.
Come on, come on.
A bird in the hand,
but two in the bush. Hold on to the one that really loves you. Hey! Do the funky chicken. Do the funky chicken.
We're at the Americana Hotel in New York City. We're big time. We come looking for Dan. Dan, we're going to eat. Dan don't want to go eat. Danny, come on, man. He opens the door, cracks the door just a little bit, and the smoke. It just, he's in there cooking. Okay? But it graduates. Florida. Miami, Florida.
Can I tell this?
No, you can't tell it, because you're not going to tell it like it needs to be told. Once again, we're going out. We're at the hotel. We're going out. Let's stop by and get Dan. Myself and Harrison Kennedy. Danny, boom, boom, boom. Come on out, man. We going to eat or whatever. No, I think I'm going to just stay in here for a while. Harrison says, man, he's up to something. Because he opens the door and this is all you get. It's about this much. So he tried to shut the door and we got our feet in the door. So push the door open. And what did we do that for? It stank. I mean, something in the room was stinking so bad. Danny, something in this room is dead or something, man. Y'all smell something. So, yeah, man, we looking all on the bed and we can't find anything. And he's, I don't smell nothing. So as we get ready to leave, I say, let's take a peek in the bathroom. We open the door. And it hits. This idiot went to Florida. He went deep sea fishing. Now, we're going to be out there for 2 or 3 more days, but he's preserving his fish in the bathtub. It's already been 2 days, and he's trying to get this fish back to Detroit.
I got the biggest fish
He's so proud of his fish. He's so proud of his fish. He's got him in a bathtub, man.
Packing him in ice.
Blood. Yeah, packed in ice and blood just oozes.
Now, beach music's got a lot of definitions, but basically it was whatever the bands were playing at the clubs would become the popular type of music for the beach and for the region. Well, general was the glass slipper that fit Cinderella. Yeah, he was the perfect fit for this region. And he brought all of his background and knowledge and his national recognition and just became the leading performer in this particular region. And he was sort of the first, I say for the exception, maybe Maurice Williams, that was the writer for the region. Before General came, most of the songs that we picked up were songs that were either one-hit wonders or they were our version of Motown or our version of Philadelphia or that type of thing. General specifically came down and started writing music that fit the whole idea of what the phenomena was.
Beach music originally is rhythm and blues music that's been adopted by this area. You got to understand that in the earlier days, when Caucasian people liked rhythm and blues music, it couldn't be known. A perfect example, Tutti Frutti by Little Richard. But Pat Boone said, Tutti Frutti, oh Rutti. Okay? Now, how it got the name beach music is they had a place that they could go where anything went. They go down to Myrtle Beach, and those people who liked that rhythm and blues music, they could play it on the jukeboxes, dance to it or whatever. And that's how it got the name, beach music. What's so confusing is the term beach music. I mean, if they would clarify, and in fact, from the stage now, try to clarify, there is a difference. Because the minute you say beach music, somebody thinks they're going to hear some Beach Boys or something like that. But if you would say Carolina beach music, you're talking about rhythm and blues with a strong crossover appeal.
He did a song back in the early 60s called 3921 40 Shape that actually turned out on the radio as called 3921 48. All the DJs were, you know, joking about this girl. That girl, 3921 48. That was even on the record label when it came out. Even, you know, here's one of those classic beach records. You know, General's not even aware of it.
I'm getting ready to sing me some authentic Carolina beach music. Sing a song on a little wall back. Give me my song.
Give me my song.
Hey, hey! Drop me in the middle of Ocean Boulevard. Here I come. You. You're such a sight to see. You're the girl for me. You set my soul afire, filling my heart with one desire, wanting to be with you. You could make a blind man see. You could make a crippled man walk.
could make the quietest man in the world talk. Every little boy in town wants to get his arms around you, but no one else will do but you. With your 39, 21 partnership, 'cause you got me going havity hate over you. Give me another hand for the boys in the band. You could make
a blind
sing,
man.
Sing.
You could make
every time I think I want to quit doing this, y'all do that shit and make me want to do this for a lifetime. Get your hands, put some hand claps when it sings, sing, sing. You could make
a blind man sing.
Come on.
You could make,
oh. Oh, sing that song. Give me that ha, 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 big boy. Ah, ha, ha, ha. Hit me, man. Every little boy in town wants to get his arms around you, but no one else will do but you. With your 39, 21 partnership, that you got me going havity hate over you.
Good times, but when you reflect on it, it's kind of sad. Because, well, I'll start from the beginning. I was with the group The Showman. I had a song called It Will Stand that was number one, like I said before, in Detroit for like 5 or 6 weeks. And they wanted, even when they were with Motown, they wanted to use my voice. When they left Motown, they called me. Little did I know that they were still in a fight with Motown and could not do any recording. Right? I'm sitting up in Detroit with nothing to do but learn. Right? And Lamont Dozier would always say, just keep your ears open because I ain't teaching you nothing. Right? Right? So, for a year or so, I did nothing but learn the art of writing a song, right? Give Me Just a Little More Time was there before I got there. They played that. That was the first thing they had me to do. Can you sing this? And they said, yeah, this is our boy, right? This is the one we're going to use. And but that year paid off. What a lot of people don't know, because I'm not really a horn blower, but after that, when they finally were able to do business, I think I had like 6 or 7 million selling songs that I had written, that I wrote, and was a part of, was BMI, Broadcast Music Incorporated, Songwriter of the Year. Had the Grammy. But when I weighed the success against the money, and the scale said clonk, and all I wanted them to do was renegotiate. They chose not to. And I, because I was on a contract to them, and they felt like I would have to give in. But I'm kind of stubborn, and I left, and I didn't go back. And they went with me, and they went out of business, which is sad because at that time they were the second largest independent black recording company next to Motown.
Pretty much when I was in college, the chairman would come to Greenville, North Carolina, and it was always a good time. So we always went, and just anywhere they played, that's where we go.
So I stayed in radio all of my education, junior high, high school, and a college. Ended up at East Carolina, among the many colleges I went to, East Carolina University in Greenville, North Carolina. Went to work for a station called WOOW, Big Wow.
The Attic was located right across the street from East Carolina University campus. We were very college-oriented. I think the Attic was one of the first college nightclubs that they were playing in. And that kind of drew them into campus life. College kids really got into them because of their high-energy show. It was more rock and roll energy level than a laid-back R&B crowd. And that's what really got the kids pumped, was the energy back and forth. Target audience is wide. Their demographic is huge. When they would play the Attic, we'd have anywhere from 18-year-olds to 60-year-olds all in there together, singing the songs, matching the lyrics.
107.9 WNCT with Steve Hardy's Original Beats Party, celebrating 33 years of nonstop beats music. Glad to present again one of the best songs in beats music. Everybody knows
the songs I play at my parties and stuff, or the parties we do, 8 to 80. I mean, when you've got people calling in on a radio show that's 8 and 9 and 10 years old requesting Gone Fishing for their dad because that's his favorite song, or Patches because play it for my granddaddy, and so you're talking to a 10-year-old live on a radio show, and then all of a sudden he's playing a song for somebody 70 years old. My brain starts working then. I said, well, so what is the age range for chairman of the board? There's not an age range.
Like, my parents listened to it a lot whenever, like, I was growing up. So I just sort of grew up with the whole, like, beach music culture, I guess.
Once again, I'm getting ready to sing one of your all-time favorites. Girls loved it, guys loved it. But I do understand this, that there's been a huge generation change. I said there's been a huge generation change. So I'm singing it for your mamas and your daddies. I said I'm singing it for your mama and your daddies. Get excited. I wish they all could be California. Girls. I said, I wish they all could be California. Girls. I do understand. I say I do understand. I say I understand. But see, back then, they didn't understand. They did not understand. Why in the hell would they put this woman up on a pedestal way out in California and we down here in Carolina? See, y'all understand. I say you understand. That means you can understand what I'm saying. Only way I can make them understand is to write me a song.
Carolina girls, Carolina girls, the best in the world. Carolina girls, you're so fine, girl, you're one of a kind. Sweet Carolina girls.
Carolina girls, best in the world.
You're so fine, you're one of a kind. You're sweet Carolina girl.
Carolina girls, Carolina girls, best in the world, best in the world.
Definitely Carolina girls, that's always a good one because we are Carolina girls.
I'm a Carolina girl.
Carolina girls, Carolina girls, best in the world.
Best girls. I don't really want to sing it.
You made me say, ooh, Carolina girls, nothing finer. Ooh, Carolina girls, nothing finer. Sweeter than candy, hotter than heat. More precious than diamonds, girl, you can't be beat. Woo!
And then it's like East Carolina girls.
Oh, East Carolina girls says East Carolina girls?
Oh no, Carolina girl, that's a t-shirt. Okay.
We're gonna straighten this mess out this evening. Come on, come on, come on, come on. Hey, we gonna sing about them Carolina girls. So come on. Carolina girls,
Carolina girls,
best in the world.
Carolina girls,
you're so fine, you're one of a kind. Sweet Carolina girls,
Carolina girls,
sweet southern fun.
Carolina girls,
shoot up tough, I can't get enough of them.
Sweet Carolina girls,
I love the way you walk. I love the way you talk, I talk.
You're so fine, you're one of a kind. Sweet Carolina girls.
California girls are sexy, and New York girls are too. But Carolina girls got good looks and sweet personality too.
Carolina girls,
sweet southern food. You're one of a kind, sweet Carolina girl. You make me say,
Carolina girl,
the sweet thing that you do.
Carolina girl, she's fine.
You're sweeter than candy,
girl, hotter than heat.
More present than diamonds, girl, you can't beat me, Flo.
Here's how I happened to join General Johnson and Chairman of the Board. I'm a musician first, you know, growing up in Detroit, you know, you had the Motown sound and you had all these musicians that played on these records. And at night, you know, we'd be on the street corner singing harmony and all that kind of stuff, you know, doing that kind of thing. And in the daytime, we have like a little band also in the neighborhood band. But when I saw Chairman of the Board, there was a TV show used to come on in Detroit that was coming from Canada called Swingin' Time. And what I liked about the group was it was like four individual guys. They were not doing routines. You know, it was individuality there, and it was very, very different. Later on, in the bands that I was in, you know, performing around Detroit, Danny Woods happened to come in the club that we were performing in. And, you know, back in the day, you would ask someone to, if someone came in, there was a vocalist, you know, they would sit in with your band. So Danny, we called him up to the stage. And Danny came, and from then on, man, we just clicked. Some of my inspirations in terms of saxophone. Number
Boots
one.
Boots Randolph.
Oh, you, man, that was my answer. Boots is now on the line, but number one is Junior Walker. But Junior was an inspiration. King Curtis was definitely an inspiration. And then at Motown, you had another guy who played baritone sax.
Beans Bowles.
That's right, Beans Bowles. I'm not a jazz player. I wish I could. I don't listen to jazz. I mean, everybody talk about John Coltrane, and I wish I could get into that, but I just grew up on the school of Motown. Oh. Speaking of funny stories, I tried them, not a jig, but Danny can tell it.
Ken can dance.
Yeah.
He can really dance.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Yeah.
So, Ken had a little dance he did.
What was this, the Russian what?
The Russian kick.
Yeah, Russian kick.
And he would cross his hand and get real low on the floor and kick. I couldn't do it. So one night he fell, and he haven't did it since.
The whole audience stood up looking over.
What happened?
Oh, that was my last Russian kick.
We're doing something that we should have done a long time ago. We're doing a Christmas album.
Very.
Right. Yes. In May.
Yeah.
Christmas album. But we started in November, right?
Yeah. Yep. Right about November.
And, it's been very inspiring, you know. No more
sorrow. Please Come Home for Christmas. Was very, very good. I mean, just solid. And that's a real touching song to me. And Charles Brown did a great version years ago. But it's going to be really, really something with the Chandler Boy. Friends and relations, send salutations.
Just as sure as the stars above. When it's Christmas time, my dear, the time.
King of Kings is powerful of a song that he's ever written, in my opinion.
A song that really stood out to me is called King of Kings, which at once you hear the song, you realize exactly what the meaning of Christmas is.
God so loved the world, he gave his only begotten son to bring salvation and peace to everyone. Born in a world of sin, Jesus died on Calvary, sacrificed his life so that we could all be free. Well, tell all the children what Christmas truly means. The day Jesus Christ was born, we celebrate the King of Kings. Lord of Lords, King of Kings, give praise to his holy name, lift every voice and sing. Lord of Lords, King of Kings, celebrate the Savior's birth. That's what Christmas means. Joy to the world, all hail the Savior's birth. Peace, joy, and goodwill
to all who dwell on earth. Enjoy festivities, exchange gifts of love, flourish in the spirit of Jesus Christ above. Go tell all the children what Christmas truly means. The day Jesus Christ was born, we celebrate the King of Kings. Lord of Lords, King of Kings, give praise to his holy name, lift every voice and sing. That's what Christmas means. Oh, Lord of Lords, King of Kings, give praise to his holy name. Let every voice and sing. Lord of Lords, King of Kings, celebrate the Savior's birth. That's what Christmas means.
One of the first times I'd heard General Johnson, chairman of the board, was in June 1970. So I was given the chore of guarding 6 Viet Cong prisoners of war to help to rebuild a sandbag bunker that was demolished, was blown up with enemy fire. And I was listening to my battery-powered radio, and as I watched them, the disc jockey announced the next song, Give Me Just a Little More Time by the chairman of the board. And I'd heard it before, I liked the song, but this time as I was listening to it, I was watching the prisoners work, and I noticed one of the prisoners was lip-syncing the words. And I watched him, and I thought that was unusual. And I asked him, did he know how to speak English? And he said yes. He attended for 2 years the University of Michigan. And I asked him how he came to be in his current predicament as a prisoner of war. And he said he came back to Vietnam because his family needed him. And then one day the North Vietnamese invaded his home, put AK-47 assault rifles to his wife's head, his father's and his mother's head, and they demanded that he come and fight in their army or they would kill his whole family. So naturally, he went with them. I thought it very unusual, you know, to find somebody like that, and who I had actually been trained and, as I said in a letter, even brainwashed to believe that they were animals, they were inhuman. And that day, he changed my mind. Changed the way I looked at the enemy, the other people. I wrote General Johnson and the chairman a letter sharing that experience with him, and I thought he would enjoy it, and all this came from it. General Johnson was one of these guys that you automatically feel comfortable with. And he's got a demeanor about him and a smile that automatically just, you like him from the first time you meet him. You know, I try not to talk about Vietnam a lot. And when I do, I like to share a positive experience, which there was so few and far between over there. And that was one of the high points. Other than R&R, that was one of my high points in Vietnam.
The styles of music of General Johnson, they're unlimited. I think he draws on so many, I mean, so incredibly many styles of music, from country music, where Jerry Reed copied Patches, Clarence Carter copied Patches after General wrote it. You hear disco, you can hear funk, you can hear the sounds of Motown tied into it, you can hear his own brand of Southern soul.
They call it, give me a touch more, they call it supply and demand. My daddy didn't raise no fool. I know what you want, so damn it, I'm gonna give it to you. Give me my song. I was born and raised down in Alabama on a farm way back up in the woods. Y'all, I was so ragged, folks used to call me Patches. Daddy used to tease me about it, but down inside he was hurt. He done the best he could. My papa was a great old man. I can see him with his shovel in his hand. See, education daddy never had. But he did wonders when the times got bad. But the little money from the crops we raised barely paid the bills we made. Oh, life whipped him down to the ground, and when he tried to get up, life would kick him back down. And that day, Papa called me to his dying bed, placed his hand on my shoulder, and in tears he said, he said, Patches, I'm depending on your son to pull my family through. My son is all I've got to you. 2 days later, Papa passed away, and I became a man that day, so I told my ma I wanted to quit school, but she said that was daddy's strictest rule. So every morning before I went to school, I fed the chickens and I chopped wood too. Sometimes I felt like I could go on. I wanted to leave, just run away from home. And I remembered what my daddy said with tears in his eyes on his dying bed. He said, Patches, I'm depending on you, son. I tried to do my best. It's up to you. One day a strong rain came, washed all the crops away. And at the age of 13, I felt like I was carrying the weight of the world off my shoulders. See, every day I had to work the fields, cause that's the only way we got our meals. See, I was the oldest of the family, and everybody else depended on me. Every night I heard my mama pray, Lord, give him strength to face another day. Years have passed, everybody's grown. My mama is resting in a brand new home. Lord knows it took a lot of sweat and tears, and my dad has brought us to help us through the years. Saying, Patches, I'm depending on you, son, to pull my family through. My son is all I've got. Sounds like somebody out there knows what I'm talking about. My daddy had been sick for a long time, flat on his back. Said my daddy had been sick for a long time, flat on his back. And every evening, after we finished our chores, had us some dinner, everybody go into Papa's room, try to make him feel a little bit better. Now this day we all gathered in daddy's room, you're feeling pretty good, when all of a sudden my daddy got that pain up in his chest again.
pain that I was too young to understand. Mama rushed all of us out the room into the hallway. She spent some time with Daddy. Then I heard Mama calling out to me.
Patches! Patches!
Can you hear her calling to me? I said, can you hear her calling to me?
Patches!
Patches, boy, you better come on in here because your daddy wants to see me. I ran running to my daddy's room and they laid in the bed with tears in his eyes. Ain't never seen my daddy cry. Put his hand on my shoulder and said, Patches. Patches, son, the hammer of life done beat your poor daddy down to the ground, boy. And your daddy ain't got nobody to help your mama with the youngins. So, son, I need you to promise me you're gonna help your ma much as you can. Well, y'all, that day I made a promise. I said, Paul, I'm gonna do my best. I tell you something, and until this day, I'm still trying to do my best. Sound good, don't it? Hey, but tomorrow is always another day. I said, tomorrow is another day, and I got to start all over again, doing the same thing that you do. You know what we do every day of our lives. We try to climb life's mountain. I said, everybody trying to climb life's mountain. Ain't you trying to climb life's mountain? Everybody's trying to climb life's mountain, and everybody's searching for a top. Sad to say, ain't no top to life. Say, ain't no top to life, but still you got to climb. And sometimes I know you do get a little tired. Don't know what y'all do, but every time I feel like I can't sing that song, can't write that song like I want. My mind goes back that day and I see them tears in my daddy's eyes. Most of all, I remember them words. Patches. Patches, boy, I'm depending on you. For God's sake, son, for God's sake, please pull my family through. Every time I feel like I can't climb life's mountain, I hear Daddy's voice, Patches. I'm depending on you, son. Pull my family through. It's all left up to you. Even right now, while I sing my song, I hear Patches. I'm depending on you, son. I try to do my best. It's up to you to do the rest.
Patches?
Patches, right. That's the one that most people say is my best song, but that's to like saying that's a part of me. All of them are part. That's like saying this child here is your, which one of these children is your
favorite
child, right? Mm-hmm. You know, I got a lot of love for all of them.
We were driving along, the general sitting next to me, and I was thinking about a song he wrote. I said, general, you know, I was thinking about your childhood. He kind of, you know, kind of looked at me, and I said, you know, when you were a little kid and everything, about such a tragic childhood, and the way you wrote about that, and it just, you know, when I hear it, and when you sing it, it just, it's almost like every time you sing that song, your childhood comes back to you, and the way you lost your father, and the way when he said Patches, when he was dying, I'm dependent on you, son, to bring the family through. And he stopped and he looked at me and I said, it was really sad. You know, I just want to tell you that. He goes, I'm from Norfolk. I grew up in the city. My father and I were on tour together and he lived to be a pretty old man. What are you talking about? I said, the song Patch. He said, I just made that up.
I think one of the coolest things I've seen that you did was the cartoon
The cartoon, the video.
The cartoon?
Yeah.
Yeah, when I was doing on the surfboard.
Yeah. But that was a different beach.
That was, what happened is I wrote a song called On the Beach.
Right.
And I forget the name of the song that, Rockaway Beach was this guy, Joey Ramone.
Right.
And we did it. He used a piece of mine, I used a piece of his.
And y'all performed that song together too.
Yeah, we did. We were doing a, I was doing a thing by myself. It was a songwriter's thing at the Bottom Line in New York. And I'm hoping he don't come, because I don't even remember how we did. But he came in and, Joey. And we had to do it. We did it together. And it's sad to say, then we started having like a real correspondence thing together, you know? We call and stuff. And then about 2 months later, I think, he died.
Wow.
He was a nice guy.
Yeah, and that cartoon with the video with y'all on the surfboards, that has to be priceless now.
I don't know.
Company, and we distribute some. We just have to do some independent distributing ourselves to mom and pop stores. But you know, you got the internet and stuff.
We have the internet, which now everybody's getting their songs and CDs. It's one outlet to call Iota.
which is called the Independent Online Distribution Association. And they distribute stuff to the Amazons, to iTunes, Napster, and just a whole another way of keeping count.
In other words, it's a blessing.
Exactly.
You know, you don't have to kowtow to major labels.
Right.
Which means give you independence. You don't have to do the music that they want you to do. You know, mm-hmm. It frees you up. Frees you up to be yourself, you know, to do
right.
what you like to do, you know. If it's not successful, it's on you. But I think the problem with major labels and stuff now is there was a time when major labels were run by people who were passionate about music, you know, understood music. Today you got businessmen, you got lawyers,
mm-hmm.
you know, basically that's what, you know, that's lawyers.
Right.
So lawyers are not interested in what's good as far as the music is concerned. You know, they just give me the money, you know what I mean, as long as we're making the money. So I like what we do as far as the recording company. And then we got the booking agency.
Right.
We book our own shows, or we're able to co-book with other agencies.
Get your hands up. You got me dangling on a string. Please don't let me drop, 'cause you're everything I've got. I'm planted in a tree, I'm needing you so. The feeling is strong and I can't let go. I'm not half the man I used to be, and I admit it, your love has become a habit to me, and I can't quit it. Girl, please take this hyper man, make this man whole again. 'Cause you, what are you doing? Got me dangling on a string. Please don't let me drop, 'cause my life would surely stop. I'm trapped in the dream of feeding the soul. My heart's in the noose and I can't break loose. I said, what's the best time of the year? Summertime. Give me them drums, give me them drums. Beat them drums, beat them. Give me a pick up, big pick. Hey, get your hands up to the. Oh! Get up, keep them hands there. Keep them right there. Keep them right there. Julie, give me some bass with these. Woo. Girl, my nights are so lonely.
My nights are so lonely.
I'm needing you only.
I'm needing you only.
Plenty, plenty good love.
You got me dangling on a string. Please don't let me drop, 'cause you're everything I've got.
I'm trapped in a dream, I'm feeding the show. My heart's in the noose and I can't break loose.
You got me dangling on a string. Please don't let me drop.
When you're writing a song, you're giving a piece of your soul. It's a lot different from performing, because a performer is like an entertainer, like an athlete, like a football player or a baseball player. But a writer actually gives a piece of their soul when they write.
Music today holds nothing compared to what we had. And in the past, you know, I think music in the past has probably, and even some of general stuff, has probably made what we have today. You know, where would we be today without your four people bringing certain sounds? Which, for instance, Kanye West and John Mayer right now just redid a song of his called Bittersweet. You know, and that's cool that John Mayer's singing the lead and Kanye wrote a little rap to it.
Give me
me just a little more time, and our love should be firm.
Yeah.
Give me just a little more time.
Yeah.
And our love surely grow. Baby. Please, babe. Give me just a little more time, and I'll love you, babe.
Yeah.
Please, babe. Just a little more time,
yeah.
And all of us will grow.
I think General Johnson has the ability to hear music before it's played, to have it within him, and it's a gift from God that no one else I think has ever had that I've ever seen that can hear it and then put it out, and people understand and appreciate what he's pulling out. To be able to do that is truly a miracle. And I think he is truly a miracle among those in the industry.
Oh, without a doubt. It's the entertainment value, the energy. Of course, the talent level has to be there to perform that. But they just, when they're finished, they're spent, they don't leave anything.
Damn it, I say I got something to say. And I'm gonna say it. Y'all ready? So y'all ready for my something to say? If you agree with me, you're gonna sing with me. I say if you agree with me, you're gonna sing with me. Here I come.
Get back.
I went to find a job in New York City. Oh, yeah, nice place to visit. But I couldn't stay too long. I missed the tall green trees. Them down home folks who speak. So I packed my bags and carried my ass back home. Yeah. Ain't loud enough. Get your hands up. Sing, sing. Yeah, y'all. Ain't. So y'all ready to jump? Why is it so basic? I said, y'all ready to jump?
Yeah!
Dan, take your pose. Damn. That's you. That's how you gonna do it?
Yeah, I'm gonna like it.
That's yours. That you can. Is the band ready? I say again, is the band ready? Y'all ready? Say, y'all ready? Get ready to jump.
Get on up.
Truckload.
Quick to get. Hey, hey.
Got some.
Come on now.
Hold on.
Hold on.
I'm coming. Cause I'm a soul man.
I'm a soul man. Yes, I am.
Said I'm a soul man.
I'm a soul man.
Say,
hey, hey. I got what I got, y'all. Yeah. The hard way. Gonna make it better. Each and every day.
Yeah.
I tell you when you get it, oh, you got something.
Yeah.
Don't you worry, I'm coming. Cause I'm a soul man. Woo-hoo. I'm a soul man. Yes, I am.
I'm a soul man.
I'm a soul man.
Let's go out with some energy.
Get
here.
Up.
Get them hands up. We're going to put them together. Let's go. Pick it up.
I'm a soul man. Soul man. Yes, I am. I'm a soul man.
Yeah, y'all.
Yeah. I'm a soul man. Hey. Hey.
Great, boy.
Chairman of the board, the backup and the incentives. The chairman of the board.
spending my time with you. I gotta hold on, I try to be strong, but my mind keeps reminding me the thought of you was someone else. I go crazy, I can't help myself, out of my mind. I go crazy, worrying about losing you, out of my mind. I go crazy, worrying about what you do.
I go crazy.
My love is real, it's so hard to deal with this love I feel for.
Charlie,
right.
Charlie,
it's smashed.
I heard it.
Smashed.
I heard it.